Hi, this is Tim from realwebsitehints.com, and I just got an email this morning saying that the CSS Hero plugin was going to be available for the Divi 2 theme. This plugin I found really intriguing when I first learned about it a few months ago. It's a front-end editor that allows you to modify the CSS of your website in real time without having to know any code. But it's compatible with only a specific set of themes, and up until this point, it wasn't really compatible with a theme that I new to be interesting to me. So now that it's compatible with the Divi theme, I thought I'd just sort of give you a quick look at what it does and how you can use it with the Divi theme. Let's go ahead and take a look. All right, so this is the blog page that I created when I did the test of the Divi 2 theme, and I didn't really like the way that the Divi 2 theme puts the image up on top, and then your title, and then your text down below, because I find that when you scroll down like this, it gets a little bit confusing as to where the image goes. So what's kind of cool is that with my just initial test just this afternoon of the CSS Hero plugin, here's the plugin, okay, we're loading it up right now, I was able to actually modify that. Did take a little bit of messing around. It does definitely help if you know a little bit of CSS. You don't have to know any code to do the modifications in CSS Hero, but it does help to sort of understand how CSS works. Even if you don't know CSS, you might as well play around and give it a shot. So you select this little widget here, and then that lets you select the element. So I want to select this image element, and then you just click on it here, so we can see the name of it right there, and then you click on it here. And I don't remember exactly what I did in my original test, but I think the first thing I did was I changed the size to make it smaller. So we'll just bring it down about like there. And then I changed the float to float left. And there we go. Now we've already instantly got a better looking blog page, in my opinion. We've got the image on one side, and then the title and text on the other side. And that sort of goes along for the whole blog page here. I only have two featured images on this page, but if I had more featured images, they'd all automatically do that. Okay, so that was pretty neat. One of the other things I didn't like about the Divi 2 theme was the spacing between some of the smaller sections I made on the homepage. Okay, so here's the homepage. One of the things I didn't like about the styling on the Divi theme is that each section's got so much space between it, especially when you've got small sections like this that you're trying to keep close together. And so once again, with the CSS Hero, I was able to fairly easily fix this. Okay, so let's scroll down here, back to where we were, use a little widget, click on the section, so we can see the section here is called Post 601 section, so we click on that. Okay, so adjust the padding. And then we'll make the bottom padding a little bit smaller, make the top padding a little bit smaller, and then save that. Another neat thing that I discovered when I was using this is that if you make a mistake, which I made a lot of when I initially tried this just this afternoon, you can actually go back really easily. Here we go. We've got all the revisions for this page, and you can go back, you know, if you know what time it was, and I think you can actually preview it here. You can go back to any of the revisions. I would still recommend, especially since I haven't done a full review of this, installing a backup program like iTheme's Backup Buddy, which I've got a video about, before you use this plugin, just because I'm, you know, still a little bit hesitant to say that it, you know, works great and does everything wonderfully, and it's always good to have some great backups. But being able to modify very easily some of the problems that I had, or some of the things I didn't like as much about the Divi theme, using this plugin is pretty phenomenal. So let me know if you'd be interested in a full review of the CSS Hero plugin. It's actually really not that expensive. It's only about $30 if you want to use it on one website right now. So if you want to give it a try, you can use my affiliate link below. And also if you use my affiliate link, you will be able to see all the themes that are compatible with it. And you can actually give it a try yourself. If you click on the Try with CSS Hero, it'll actually open up a view of the theme, and you can do just what I was doing without having to buy the theme at all. So that's pretty neat. So there you go, just a quick look at the CSS Hero plugin.